Hi everybody, my name is Vicentiu Ciorbaru. I am a software developer from MariaDB Foundation, and today I'm going to highlight a couple of interesting features in MariaDB, namely JSON support and the extension of functionality that MariaDB provides. So a lot of people are using NoSQL databases these days. However, MariaDB is just as capable in supporting NoSQL workloads, especially due to the JSON functionality that it has implemented all the way back since MariaDB 10.2. Now, I don't want to keep this video very long, so we're going to dive right into it. We're going to simulate a save game database. We're going to design our own strategy game, and we're going to save the status of the game in its in a unstructured format, a JSON column data type. So the way to do this, I'm going to create a table. It's going to be called games. We're going to store all save game data in it. We're going to have a player ID. We're going to mark when it starts. And the most important thing, we're going to save the data in JSON. So nothing else, that's all I'm going to define. So let's create this a game data database and this table in it. But before we do that, let's have a look at what version of MariaDB I'm using. So the version is MariaDB 10.5.2. So all here applies to the most recent version, and mostly it should work with other versions as well. So now I've added this table. So notice that again that the data type is actually JSON here. However, if we do a show create table games, we're going to see that game data is actually a long text. And this long text has a constraint called JSON valid. Now, this is the first function in MariaDB that we're going to look into. Whenever you try to insert something into MariaDB JSON column, if it's not valid JSON, it will not work. And we can try that right now. So insert into games, I'm going to insert in an invalid document. I'm going to pretend I forgot to mark the key with an appropriate value. And you see that the constraint has failed. If I add here a correct key and a value combination, then this row, it gets inserted no problem. So far, so good. Now, applications might generate data a bit differently, so they might not always generate this compact representation. They might have an empty space here, and an empty space here, and an empty space here. So with all these spaces, this is going to be a problem. But let's see how. Well, MariaDB just stores all the spaces as is. And unfortunately, this means it eats up space. And the more of this white space you have, the more space your database is going to take. There's a very simple way how to clean this up. And we have a nice function called JSON compact. So we can update game data to set, we can update games to set the game data to be the same value as before, but wrapped inside JSON compact. We've updated both rows. Let's see how they look now. They both look identical. So JSON compact has taken care of all the unnecessary white space. Good. First thing's done. We're storing things efficiently. Now we want to modify them. How do we modify them? Well, I'm going to update this JSON. Let's say the first one, I want it to also have a proper entry. So I'm going to update it. I'm going to update game data. Let's set game data to be equal to, I'm going to use JSON insert to put a map key in it. So the way JSON insert, it's a function with three parameters. The first one is the actual JSON we're going to insert into. And I want to insert from this one into this one according to a certain path. So the path starts at the root of the document and then it ends with the key. So the key is going to be map. And I'm going to put in here, let's say that the map name is called prototype and the extension of it is map. And I'm going to insert this. So let's see what happens. Well, we now have two JSON documents with an extra map key inside and the value is set accordingly. Now, I don't like this key here. I want to get rid of this one. So the way we get rid of this one is with the opposite of JSON insert, JSON remove. So let's remove it. I'm going to say JSON remove, again, from game data. And I only need to specify the path, and the path is going to be, I want to remove the key from the game data. So let's have a look. Now, well, got rid of that bogus value. And now I want to change the map name. Maybe I got the extension wrong or I don't want to store it at all. Let's say I don't want to store the map's extension at all. So I'm going to say I want to update it. Well, updating is done with JSON replace. Again, we take the JSON value as the first parameter that we're going to change. We're going to change the map. So the path starts from the root, goes all the way to the map key. And the map key has a new value now, and the value is going to be called prototype. Prototype. So now I was able to change the extension without recreating the whole document from scratch. So now that we know how to insert, delete, and update stuff in JSON, the trickiest part is searching for stuff in it, or not necessarily searching, but getting stuff from it. So for this, I need a much more complicated example. So let's go back to our data SQL file and I'm going to insert this value here. So we have our map called prototype pod this time, and we have some player assets inside and some computer assets. Now the player assets contain some resources, some units, some buildings, and the computer only gets one unit. So let's insert this. I'm just going to source the file, because it's easier. It's going to override whatever I have created before, but it's fine for our example. So now let's have a look at this awesome function that is JSON extract. So this one is very useful. First of all, let's have a look at the data. Select star from games. What do we have? Well, we have this long JSON and it's not pretty printed. Let's pretty print it first. We can print game data by using JSON detailed. We get a much nicer representation. So the representation is one key per row. And if it's either a object or an array inside, it's going to go to the next row. So here we have a map, and then we have the prototype, prototype for the map, and then we have player assets, resources, units, etc. So let's say I want to get all the units that the player has, only the player for now. So I can do this with JSON extract. So let's do a JSON extract. The function takes the JSON document, so that's going to be game data, and then it takes a path of what it should get me. So I want it to start from the root. I want it to give me to go to player assets, and I want it to give me all the units. Let's see how this looks. Okay, I got something wrong. What did I get wrong? Let's have a look at our data one more time. So, we start from the game data. We look at player assets. Okay, and then, oh, it's not unit, it's actually called units. So, notice that if the path is wrong, you get a null value. So now with units, I get the whole array of units for that player. And this might be okay, but maybe I only want to get the type of the units. So what if I do, I can get the first value of the array. Okay, now I got the footman, and I can get the type of it. But I want to get the types of all the units for that player. Well, that thing is very easy to get because we can replace the index of the array with a wildcard. And that means to get all the values from that array, whatever goes off after it. So with this, I get footman and peasant. And basically, this is what I was after. We can extend this. We can get stuff from the computer assets. And we see that the computer only has a grant available. Right, so now we know how to both insert, update, delete, and search. There's many more functions available, and some of them have been added to the more recent versions of MariaDB. I will not go into them on this video, but let me know in the comments if this is something that is interesting for you, and I will gladly do more videos. Thank you so much for your paying attention.